son of these. Don't you dare come back or fall up and count it tomorrow.
I won't forget this. He certainly will be back, like you said.
The spook monster scuttles off into the night. The food monster left behind a special item. It appears to be a cookbook, but upon closer inspection, it's so much more. It's a book of magic spells with a golden chicken on the cover. You open the cover and find a library card tucked inside. The last name to have signed it out is Borko.
Borko. That name sounds strangely familiar.
Your blood is pumping as you stand in the quiet of the night, holding the mysterious book in your hands. As you come down from the battle buzz, you realize that your final attack has left you completely depleted. The world around you begins to fade away. Without any energy to keep your eyes open, darkness overtakes you. The image of Colonel Sanders flashes before your eyes as you fall asleep. He must have helped you get home. In your tired state, you don't know if you could have made it without him. What a guy. You want to thank him, but you don't have the strength to utter a single word. You feel your covers being pulled tightly up over you as you are tucked in tightly.
Good night, my colonel.
In your dreams, you're together with Colonel Sanders. For some reason, Sprinkles is also there, instructing your love. Dreams are weird. You awake on day two, and attempt to process the wild visions you had. Were they memories or premonitions? You lie in bed and stare at the ceiling, thinking about the secret you discovered while tasting Colonel Sanders' cooking room. So you can't believe he really used heroin. And then there was that secret ingredient that Colonel Sanders went ahead and told you outright. Not much of a secret, huh? Probably just because he already trusts you so much. Sure, that makes sense. We'll go with that. Meet up with your bestie and a friend of the school. Before you can tell her about the encounter you had with this pork monster, she launches into a story of her own.
Okay, I know this might sound a little strange, but I think I might be, I think I might like Pop.
Like him? Like him?
I know, it sounds like it's moving too fast, but there's something about him. I like him. Like him.
You got to go. No, crap. Sorry about that. Got to get the time. Nah, forget it, I won't.
Did you know that Colonel Sanders enlisted in the army when he was only 3?
Well, I mean, that would be kind of scary. He was born in 1890. Yeah, in 1893, there was an actual war called the Spanish-American War that he could have fought in if he was in the army at that time.
Not only that, but he founded a special unit of super soldiers who wear the same hats just because he put a hat on one time and thought it looked cool.
Sounds like either the Green Berets or the Avengers. Not the Colonel Sanders. Colonel Sanders doesn't even wear a hat. He wears a ribbon tie. Great ties. I love those things. Either way, maybe it'd be best if you took it slow with the new boy, like I am with Colonel Sanders.
You and Colonel Sanders, the coolest guy in school, the most famous student to ever attend University of Cooking School Academy for Learning, you're a thing now.
You definitely connected yesterday.
Sure you did. You're great. Why wouldn't he be into you, I guess?
Laughing at the implication that you and Colonel Sanders might be a thing is definitely not cool. You are great. You have an idea about how to prove your love is real.
Well, if he's not into me, why did he tell me one of his secret ingredients?
However, you don't tell her that you know a second ingredient too, which you discovered on your own. Your bestie's eyes light up.
Secret ingredient.
Yeah, I just said that. A secret ingredient. Is there a dramatic echo in here? Yes, there very much is. Ma'am, check to make sure that you're alone before continuing.
So this summer, while I was on vacation with my family, a lovely man approached me in the botanical gardens where I was wandering.
This can't be good.
He told me all about his passions for spices. Secret spices. The man even gave me some, showed me what he meant. He said it was a powder created from super duper rare dried flower petals. And that if I did him a big favor, I could have some of my own.
Please, Aaron, don't tell me.
So I filled my suitcase with them and brought them home.
Wow, she just bought cocaine off of some guy in a botanical garden. That's weird.
He was so nice, he even met me at the gate when I arrived. Later when I cooked with them, a very strange feeling came over me. And the flavor was unlike anything I've ever tasted.
Yep, cocaine. She got addicted to cocaine, that's nice.
I think you're being very liberal with the meaning of spices here. Whatever. We both share an interest in cooking, so we stayed in touch. You know, like pen pals. I bet he would love to know more about new spices. Oh, I bet he would.
Well, I'm definitely not supposed to share Colonel Sanders' secret recipe. And besides, I only know the one ingredient, so I doubt it'd be much for use to anyone.
Please, 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 please. It would mean the world to me. No one has to know it came from you or from Colonel Sanders.
What do you think? Should you protect Colonel Sanders' secret or share it with your bestie? Make up a fake ingredient. Quickly think of a fake ingredient name. I don't know. How about...
I have nude. I know. It sounds like kind of witch's potion, but what are you gonna do? I have nude. Wow.
Pause, let up imagining such a thing, and you figure that you've satisfied her curiosity and she'll move on. However, she immediately turns around and does some phone typing on her phone that you can't quite see. That's probably not good. Before you can ask her to confirm that she was definitely not texting secrets to other people, you're interrupted. A wind rushes in. Cherry blossom petals fill the air. That could only mean one thing. It's Colonel Sanders. He's arriving at school like any southerner. Stand back and admire his majestic glory. Colonel Sanders' horse is truly a thing of beauty. Without even acknowledging that he's being watched, he does a short horse dance before dismounting from the floors. He then slaps the beautiful creature gently on its rear, sending it running free into the countryside. You are so struck by the sight of him that you lose the ability to speak coherently.
I didn't realize anyone was watching. Don't worry, he knows his way home.
You attempt to compliment Colonel Sanders, but the words don't come out exactly right.
What a horse of what beauty you have there. I mean, what a horse of... What a horse of what beauty you have. Dang it, that's what I just said.
Being a good friend, Miriam attempts to cover for you.
Oh, Claudia just gets real nervous around people they like.
What? That's not helping.
I mean, they got food poisoning and were up all night. It was gruesome. You should have seen it.
She gives you a wink and a smile as if to say, situation handled. Can't blame a girl for trying. Your Dr. Colonel Sanders disappears into the school, leaving you and Miriam alone. When you enter the classroom, you can see your two rivals, Ashley and Von Von, are doing something bad. By the way they're hiding, you know it'd be really bad. Like counterfeiting recipes bad, experimented with restricted ingredients bad, summoning a demon bad? You try and get a peek over Von Von's hulking shoulder, but he sees you coming.
Whoa there, little one. I'm not sure you're ready to handle this.
Why don't you make like a bee and mind your own wax, honey? Tell them to stop acting mature, act like you're not interested in them, but really try to get closer look. You sit near the arrivals before, but leave your back turned to them. You even hear Von Von mutter something that sounds a bit like a magic spell. However, he notices you eavesdropping. You try to cover your tracks and improvise an excuse.
Ahem. It's time for class and you're distracting the rest of us who want to learn.
Now you've upset them. Oh, and you're the Emperor of Cooking, are you?
No, crap, wrong person. Oh, and you're the Emperor of Cooking, are you? You make the rules?
I'm not sure you'd know a good meal if it ate you.
Being the best chef in the world takes more than just culinary skills. It takes creativity. It takes apache.
And it doesn't hurt to use a little evil.
You finally get a look at what it was they were hiding, and you instantly recognize it. It's a book, just like the one you found after the encounter of the spook monster. That's the same book I found last night in the quad. Ashley immediately eyebrows Von Von, elbows of Von Von, who hides the book behind his back.
I don't know what you're talking about. That book is a family heirloom, and its contents are secret.
He knows that they haven't been studying the book. They've got Pop pinned to the wall, and they're tossing potato skins at him as he tries to catch them in his mouth.
We're playing!
Before you can dig in any further, you're interrupted by the arrival of more students. It's almost time for class. Clank must be running late. He's in such a hurry that he rolls over Von Von's meaty foot.
Hey, watch it, you bucket of bolts.
You watch how you talk to him. He didn't do anything. Who do you think you are talking to? I've never heard such language, not even from a stand mixer. Womp, womp.
No, your mother was a stand mixer.
Von Von jumps to attack Clank, but Clank shocks Von Von, sending him flying across the room.
Oh, protect me, Colonel Sanders. These crazed men are about to come to blows. I think it might be over for me.
Ashley's tone has completely changed in an instant. She bats her eyelashes at Colonel Sanders. Surely he must know this is a ruse, right?
Gentlemen, get a hold of yourselves. Save it for the arena, at least. Or don't. Honestly, why do I care? I've got a lofty career of aspirations to focus on.
Maybe I can help you with your business plan.
Just then, Sprinkles arrives to signal the true start of the class. As there, he's patting, which doesn't seem that abnormal. He's a professor, but he's also a dog.
Students! Please take your seats! I apologize for my late arrival. I spent the morning chasing a car all around town, and my tiny legs are very, very tired. But I'm here now, and I hope that you're ready to learn.
Rub his furry. His furry.
Furry!
His furry dog belly. He loves it.
After he catches his breath, Sprinkles regains control of the classroom.
How fit I do! We'll reveal the global history of my favorite fool, the chicken!
You want to pay attention to the lesson? Truly, you do.
Which is why in 1776, at the signing of the Declaration of Independence, it was a chicken who first signed a name.
But you can't help but daydream about Colonel Sanders. And you miss most of the important parts.
When you come to, Sprinkles is holding a tray of food in front of you.
Well, Claudia?
Naturally, this appears to be a sample platter. Which item do you want to sample? Never steal dog's biscuit. A shimmering pepper sounds spicy. I don't want to eat that. A glass of water. Grab the glass of water and gulp it down. It's cool and crisp, like the pure snow melted on the mountain spring.
Hey, that is mine! It's from my favorite toilet! You owe me $6!
You.
And you've got excellent taste.
Think to yourself, geez, I should pay attention better.
We all make mistakes. I'm sure he'll forgive you. Someday. Come on, it's time for lunch.
Before anyone can relax, the cafeteria lights dim. And then, and your rivals enter to make a dramatic announcement.
Today's lunch will be prepared, pal.
By a timed competitive cook-off. Level of reaction mix with these two is off the charts. Demand they stop wasting everyone's time? Nah, that's not cool. Step up and tell them, you're on! Yeah, boy! A bit of lunchtime competition, eh? Count me in! If I have to wipe the tables with your fool, if you fooled before I set my lunch down on it, then so be it.
I'm not the fool, fool. You're the fool, fool.
Good one, Bron Bron. I like your gumption, Claudia. I'll be watching your performance.
Just as things reach a boiling point, Prinkle steps in. Surely you'll put a stop to this madness.
Now, students, please settle down. This is a lunchroom, not a sports routine court.
Finally, a little sense. You breathe a sigh of relief.
At least not until we turn on the timer.
Just in a... And a huge light blasts in your face, flashing the words, "Timer ready." Oh my god. No, it can't be.
That's what I'm talking about.
I stand corrected.
The hard way builds so solidly a foundation of confidence that cannot be swept away. And that's an original quote by me, in case anyone was wondering. Hope its message lifts you to victory.
Like a diamond!
Like a diamond, I was formed under pressure, and now it's my chance to shine. And I will defeat you myself! You had his chicken and you made mashed potatoes and gravy one day, and you're feeling like you can really impress him again here. It's time to boil some water for the potatoes. Think fast, time runs on, you'll be forced to pick randomly. This one. That's right. How would you have even gotten to this goal without knowing that?
Well, it gets the roof of my furry belly. But that enticing offer motivate you.
You're going to need to season the chicken before you cook. Don't know how much sandwich what to play exactly, but you have an idea. How many herbs and spices can you use?
11 herbs and spices.
That's right. You might not know all of the ingredients yet, but at least you're headed in the right direction.
Tail wagging intensifies!
Now you've got some basic steps going, it's time to elevate your craft. And gratitude. That's right. You must take the opportunity. You must never take this opportunity for granted if you hope to succeed. By the way, I'm not reading this because of the timer and I don't want to miss anything, so sorry. Your classmates are rooting for you, but Ashley is simply stronger and faster than you. You better pick up the pace if you want to survive. Your child, your father told you to never forget where you came from. Every day you meditate on his advice and draw energy from that place. This one?
That's wrong! What?
This is a horrible time to start forgetting important things. Next question. You try to shut down the noise on the arena and focus on your cooking. What is the sound? It says, silence.
That's right.
When they taste your cooking, they'll be so taken with it that they'll be unable to speak. Nose car sound is out the corner of your eye.
I believe in you, Claudia.
He's actually cheering for you on. Which would be awesome, except knowing he's watching you makes you totally forget what you're doing. Now all you can think about is Colonel Sanders. How many spoonfuls of gravy should... Oh, God, what are you thinking? Get your mind back in the competition. You are stranded on a desert island with only one desert cookbook. Which do you take? What a hunk.
I know, right? You know what? Should you be focusing on the challenge? You're falling behind.
Sorry, I forgot the question. You and Colonel Sanders walking on me.
What does that have to do with Crafting's particular fried chicken group? You're really struggling to keep up. At the next station over, Ashley has begun planting the elements of her dish. It's colorful and complex. To make up for time, you toss your biscuit dough onto a stand mixer. As you do, the crowd gasped.
Yikes.
I know you love nothing more than seeing a fellow appliance utilized in a kitchen battle, but sometimes that means sacrificing the personal touch. You might not have any hands, but Claudia does, and a good chef needs to be touching the dough to know when it's properly mixed.
There's an easy way and a hard way. Don't get far by going the easy way.
When you hear everyone talk and you realize how serious your error was, you immediately shove your hand into the mixer here to rescue the dough before it's overmixed.
Claudia, no!
But you're not fast enough, and your hand gets stuck. It's immediately crushed by the quickly spinning beaters. There's no way you'll be able to use that hand for the rest of the match. Colonel Sanders shakes his head in shame.
What you often find is that the easy way can turn out much, much more difficult.
Everyone stop what you're doing right now! This battle is over! Arf, arf!
Oh, it can't be. I was so close to finishing my dish.
Sweetheart, look at your hand. You simply can't go on.
That's too bad.
And oh, crap. Sorry, keep accidentally this place, but
no, it wouldn't be fair to compare these two on account of Claudia's injuries.
Oh, wait, now I think I know what you said.
Too bad. And here I am with a fully finished disc ready to be eaten.
You see Sprinkles begin to lick his doggy chops as he locks onto the dish.
But I suppose you should at least tell us what you prepared, Arthur.
Because I'm the sweetest, I skip straight to dessert. Under this white chocolate dome,
you'll find a ride away of delights, taking you on a journey of flavor that tastes good and tells a story of excellence. I was going to ask Claudia to do the honors. But since you're injured, I'm afraid that pouring this cream of delicate hot chocolate sauce might be too difficult.
Colonel Sanders, if you wouldn't mind lending me your strong, steady hand.
Colonel Sanders pours the hot chocolate sauce on top of the dome, causing it to melt away, revealing the ingredients hidden within.
Inside, you'll find a delicate fried cheese croquette atop a slice of honeycomb, ice cream two ways, tender nougat and pearly, and pearls of blue blueberry jelly.
Colonel Sanders seems intrigued, but perhaps not impressed as he dips his finger in the hot chocolate sauce.
Simplicity isn't your strong suit, is it, Ashley?
Oh, you?
As he places a sauce-covered finger into his lips, Ashley leans over and whispers something into his ear. A dab of sauce sticks to his mustache, just up between Colonel Sanders and Ashley. You reach out with your apron to wipe the sauce off his glistening face. Colonel Sanders recoils and brushes your back.
Oh, this goatee isn't just a fatness station. It's also functional. I was saving that flavor for later.
Game over. What? No! I'll have to try again, then. Oh, crap. Does that mean starting this whole competition again? I hope not. That would be, that would make me pretty angry. Come on, load already! Load! Come on, load. Sorry if you hear background noise, by the way. My younger siblings are up at this time right now, and they're talking, and I don't like that. So, yeah. Before anyone can relax, the cafeteria lights dim. I'm not reading all this again. Make a dramatic entrance. Let's just skip all this. Yeah, I grabbed the furry belly, you stinking furry. 11 herbs and spices. Tail wag intensifies, yada yada yada. Just get gratitude. That's wrong. What? Oh, that's all of them then. Silence or sound. Let me skip all this. Come on, don't want to put up with any of this stuff. This stuff is stuff you're wholesome. Oh, okay then. Your rage burns so intensely within your eyes that they burst into flames. The flames cause your eyebrows to catch on fire and turn to ash. And they fall off your face, which means people will have a hard time understanding your emotions for the rest of the semester. Perhaps forever. Embarrassed and ashamed by your poor performance, not to mention your crispy fried brow, you run for the quad to be alone. The beautiful weather feels like such an insult. Deep inside of you, a storm rages. It's Colonel Sanders. He's probably here to tell you that he and Ashley are in love and have decided to get married. The worst possible fate! And he won't even ask you to be the caterer at their wedding because you're a terrible chef and an awful person. Try to hide from him, but he pushes you directly.
I know you're hurting right now. Not just from that devastating loss, but from that running with the mixer and that small fire. We should get that checked out.
I'm fine. Can't you see? Can't you just leave me alone? I'm a loser. I'm not fit to fill your fire. I'll never be a master chef.
Failure is a part of life. Not just for you, but for all of us. Do you think I've never failed at anything before?
That's exactly what I think.
Well then, think again. I wasn't always the man you see before you. Enrolled in culinary school, incredibly handsome, successful, motivated. Well, handsome, sure. I was born that way.
Ooh.
But I've walked other paths and arrived at dead ends. I was passionate about life, but I failed as an obstetrician. I was passionate about justice, but I failed as a lawyer. I was passionate about livestock, but I even failed at the mule handler. That one was especially humiliating. Mule can be so cool. All true about Colonel Sanders. He had a lot of jobs before the success as KFC. At one point, he was living in a car on the side of the road, living only on his social security payments.
I lost my business partner to a gunfight.
I didn't know.
Oh crap, I missed the line, I think.
People see my delicate ribbon tie and my royal cap beard and assume that I've always got it all together, which is true now, but I haven't always been. And think yourself for a second, there was something about him having killed his rival in that same gunfight, which did actually happen in 1910, I believe. Yeah, that sounds right.
Sounds like this guy really used a hug.
I resolved that I was going to amount to something. No amount of hours, labor, or money would deter me from giving the best I had to give.
As Colonel Sanders changed his focus, you can see something innate inside of him, a burning passion.
One has to remember that every failure can be a stepping stone to something better. My new dream is pure, it's honest, it's something that a humble man and a crisp white suit can be proud of. I will create a new chain of chicken restaurants that will bring joy to the entire world and make up for my past misdeeds.
Just as your moment grows intimate, you're interrupted by a threatening, shadowy presence.
Battle scarred from the last night, report for your watch.
It's the Spork Monster!
Borko?
It is I! I know I said I wouldn't be back, and after the whole fight to the Death Ring, maybe you don't want to see me anymore, but I just wanted to say that I was wrong to attack you, and I apologize. I know what it's like having to always at least look over your shoulder. Monster problems, am I right?
Oh, thanks, Borko. I'm glad there are no hard feelings. Getting jumped by a giant creature in the dark of night can really be rile a person up. I just want to apologize for the way I switched right into attack mode.
Know that you are strong and a cooking school can put a person under a lot of stress. I actually used to go to the school. I was always a spark monster, you see.
I don't believe it. You are human once?
Well, no, I was a golden retriever.
Oh my gosh, a golden retriever.
But I'm still a student, so one day some mean kid with a magic spellbook cast a dark enchantment on me, and I was forever transformed.
A magical spellbook?
Precisely. I had a procured a copy for myself, but somewhere along the way I've lost it. If you find such a book, I beg of you, respect it. You're a powerful chef, and you shouldn't rely on such dark and evil magic. No, you shouldn't. You should be protecting the innocent from those who would cheat hit them through sorcery and goyim. If you need me, don't fear. I will be there.
It sounds like there are some bad cooks in the kitchen of life. Claudia, together I am sure we can defeat them. Come back. Come back to my hideaway and we can discuss.
A personal invite. You can't imagine what Colonel Sanders' home must be like, but it sounds like you're about to find out. Stepping inside Colonel Sanders' home, surrounded by his fiends, you start to feel a special bond for you.
Wait a minute. What is that? Is that the real Colonel Sanders? With some... other guy standing in front of KFC? Looks like it. And is this the real Colonel Sanders right here? It looks like you live such an exciting life.
Colonel Sanders.
Every day can be an adventure if you approach it with the right attitude. Long ago, I made the decision to never stop searching, never stop working, never stop imagining. Have you been working on any new recipes of your own lately? I'm always excited to talk about food with another ambitious chef.
Well, there is something. It's just a side dish that I've been tinkering with, trying to find the right balance of flavors and textures. I'm not sure I've nailed it yet, but I'm close. Ooh, I hope it's the mac and cheese. I love KFC mac and cheese.
Colonel Sanders' eyes perk up as he starts to wonder what this dish you might be describing.
It's meant to be paired with something spicy or something crispy. Both, perhaps?
Now you've got him right where you want him. Should you reveal your new creation to him or keep it a secret just for you?
Come on, really? He told us the secret cocaine ingredient in his chicken. So why not reveal reveal the fact that we have some side dish? Most likely either coleslaw or mac and cheese, I think, this would be the choice.
It's sad that you are as ready as you'll ever be to share your original cooking with Colonel Sanders.
Before you can talk yourself out of it, you decide to dive in headfirst. You reach into your lunch bag for a special dish that you've been keeping on ice all day. I present to you my original coleslaw. Oh my gosh, I love your coleslaw too. The shredded cabbage dish glistens the light of Colonel Sanders' Lux Hideaway.
Magnificent.
Together, you chow down on the creamy slaw until just a spoonful remains in the bowl.
Do you mind if I hold on to the last bite?
I'd like to have it around so that way I can admire it and taste it. Its taste later and think back to this moment. Okay, hang on. Before I continue, I need to ask this question. Is this going to be a game where, like, he's pretending to fall for me and then he's going to steal all my recipes and open KFC without me? That'd be messed up if that's the point of the game, but I'd find it a bit funny. You could offer to make him more, but he seems like a very sentimental kind of guy. Sure, why not?
Please make yourself comfortable. I'll be back in just a moment.
You realize now would be the perfect time to do some snooping. What a bad friend.
Around the room there are various items that you can look at. Each item seems to radiate good memories and emotion.
Tap on an item to discover more about the Colonel. Oh my gosh, they really do. This window. You gaze out the window across the vast lake and the mountain range beyond. Just then the ghost of student pops in.
Are you thinking about heading out into the world on a quest to avenge my dad?
Wait, what? I never even learned your name. Why would I avenge you?
I could just tell you my name right now.
Can't you see I'm in the middle of something? You open the window crack and the ghost of student is swept out hover for a breeze. Tap an item to discover more about the Colonel. Ooh, look, a chicken. It's taxidermy chicken. You notice a very realistic chicken stuffed. Very realistic stuffed chicken sitting on a corner table. When you pick it up, you realize it isn't just realistic, it's real. Taxidermy? Must have been important to Colonel Sanders when it was alive. A little note clipped on the chicken's foot reads,
"The true state bird of the great state of Kentucky."
Tap on an item to discover more about the Colonel. Candle. A scented candle. You pick it up and try to identify the smell. Power tool? Freshly starched collar? Piece of wood floating in a lake? Summer of 69?
That's summer smell if it's the summer of 69.
No, it's one of the secret ingredients. It's heroin! Tap in an item to discover more about the Colonel. Ooh, it's comb. A lock of silver hair is woven through the teeth of the comb. Upon further inspection, you realize that the hair therein isn't just silver in color, it's actually made of spun silver.
Really?
Tap on an item to discover more about the Colonel. Ooh, this opened up. I want to check out these pictures first. One of the framed folders shows an old man who looks a bit like Colonel Sanders, standing with a friend. They hold a fried chicken drumsticks and appear to be cheering with them. They are not holding those. I don't see them. But that is the original Colonel Sanders in front of the original Kentucky Fried Chicken, I think. Look closely and see that there's a short inscription. I wonder who my friend Pete is. Ooh, that must be this could either be the original Colonel Sanders or my friend Pete, but I'll take a look down later. The photo appears to be Colonel Sanders, except he's an old man visiting the pyramids of Egypt. Maybe this is where I discovered one of the secret herbs and spices? Maybe. Tap on an item to discover more about the Colonel. Oh, by the way, I don't know everything about Colonel Sanders, but did the real Colonel Sanders actually visit Egypt at one point? Let me know in the comments. An adorable baby boy, he crawls across on the floor. From the goatee and the mustache combo he sports, I figure that this must be Colonel Sanders himself. That, or maybe it's the drumstick that he seems to be waving like a rattle. Who frames a baby picture of just themselves? Probably the same type of person who would make their own face the logo of the company they founded, am I right? Oh, that's so funny.
Actually, I'll be honest, I think the original KFC logo did not have Colonel Sanders' face in it, so I don't know if that joke implies to Colonel Sanders. Have an item some more about the Colonel. What's this one? Take a closer look at the large urn sitting on a nearby pedestal. There's a plaque on it. It's dusty, but when you wipe it off, you can read the inscription. It says, "Here lie. Here lie the ash of all my past careers and business." Oh my gosh, that's too funny. Poor guy. Tap on an item to discover more about the Colonel. Ooh, the safe. This must be where he keeps the secret recipe. You think for a moment, what number is important to Colonel Sanders? Then it dawns on you. As soon as you dial to 11, 11, 11, the safe opens. Inside it, you find a single note. Is there something significant about the date November 11th, 2011? Let me know. Or 1911 even, maybe, so... Inside it, you find a single note. Can chicken be prepared Kumi style? I don't know. Tap an item, discover more about the Colonel. Oh my gosh, it's a jacket. You open the door to Colonel Sanders' closet and find a row of his signature white suits hanging thin. You take one of them, one off its hanger, try it on. The jacket is a bit big for you, but it's soft and comfortable. Give yourself a deep hug, breathing in his scent. They say that home is where the heart is. Is this what they meant? Before you can look any further, you hear Colonel Sanders returning. He has a new dish that he's been working on, and he wants you to taste it. Try to act casual until he asks you why you're wearing his jacket. I don't usually loan those out, but I must say, it does look good on you. Oh crap, the jacket. You've got to take it off. So now's your moment to make a big move. You fess up and tell the truth. You confess. I think I've developed feelings for you. I might be developing feelings for you too, but I'm concerned. I can't let anything get in the way of my dreams. Overwhelmed, you take off his jacket and run for the door. But the thought of leaving Colonel in the midst of such emotion breaks you due to a pause to stop yourself. Colonel? Yes, Claudia? I honestly think this may be the beginning of something wonderful. I think you're right. We should take things slow. Talk late into the night and drift off into a slumber. Dream sequence! You awake to a beautiful morning in Colonel Sanders' hideaway. Did you make the right decision on how to respond to Colonel Sanders? Only time will truly tell. Today is a day that could change the rest of your life. You think about the new secret ingredient you just learned about. Heroin. In some jurisdictions, heroin isn't even legal. But if the recipe is a secret, how will they know? Your thoughts are interrupted when Colonel Sanders emerges into the room. He's holding a gorgeously plated breakfast, and your mouth waters at the sight of it. Here's a simple breakfast I just whipped up. Oh my gosh, oh cheese and biscuits, oh my gosh. Meticulous. Oh my gosh. You taste Colonel Sanders' food and it takes you on a journey. When you return, he's waiting to ask you an important question. So, would you say that we're the perfect match? How presumptuous. My cuisine and your taste buds, that is. Oh, such confidence, such great. Could he be the world's greatest gift to cookery? Platinum, you know, I think we might make a great team. A single tear begins to pour in the corner of his eyes as he gazes out the window. And with the right business partner, I know I can't fail. Business partner? Can he be talking about you? It's all so happening so quickly. Overcome with emotion and confused by your feelings, you're on the verge of tears. Unable to speak, the only answer you can find is to run out the door and get to home. There's still one more day of school after all. The University of Cooking School Academy for Learning waits for no one. You get home to find something very surprising. Your best friend is there waiting for you.
Where have you been? Because I had one heck of a night. I've been so desperate to talk to you about it, but I couldn't find you. I got so worried that something had happened to you.
It's okay, I was just...
But now that it turns out you're fine, I can finally get you up to speed on that Sega... On the Sega of Miriam.
I play that game.
Sure, but... You will not believe what happened to me after school yesterday. I went on a date!
Oh my gosh, I'm so happy for her. I think I can believe that.
Since I'd been partnered up with Pop, he asked me to go out with him. Of course, I told him, you better harness those wild horses, young man. I'm not that kind of... Better harness those wild horses, young man. I'm not that kind of girl. But he was just interested in spending some one-on-one time together and getting to know me, so I said, yeah, sure, I can get to know the little guy. Long story short, he took me to his favorite
shush house. Is that a kind of place a kid can take another college student?
I crap, I didn't finish it, sorry. Did she just say shush house as if that's a thing people just say?
What is that even referring to?
And now I'm not really sure where we stand.
I didn't read that whole thing. I'm sorry. I forgot. You don't give Miriam time to tell her the whole story, however. Bottling up details of your own night is just too much to bear. And I went on a date, too. Back to Colonel Sanders' house, where I spent the night with him.
You what?
Nothing happened, but the emotional connection. Wowzers. Miriam offers to support you no matter what you do. Aw, thank you, Miriam. Together with your bestie, you feel you can do anything. When you arrive at school, you encounter your rivals in the quad. Then, actual thing, you can tell from a distance that they're picking on Pop. Though he himself might not quite grasp that fact. Because, you know, he's Pop.
What's a swirly? It sounds delicious.
No, it's not. No, it's not. Let me do that again.
What's a swirly? It sounds delicious.
Oh, it's great. I'll order you up one right away, Way.
I'll have my swirly with sprinkles, please. Sprinkles is a dog and a treat.
No, you don't want it with sprinkles.
You can get your swirly dipped too.
No, you don't want a swirly.
Why don't you pick on someone your own size? Because I'm literally the biggest person at this school.
Well, then don't pick on anyone then. Problem solved.
There was that one horse that Colonel Sanders rides to school. But who would dare pick on such a gentle and beautiful creature?
I don't know, you ask me. You tell me.
You've got some nerve, Claudia, suggesting I pick on a defenseless horse.
Now you're twisting my words, and I won't have it. You clench your fist, but the injury from yesterday's mixer accident makes you wince in pain.
Doesn't look like you can go on cooking like that. That might as well just give up.
I'll never give up. Ever.
Colonel Sanders arrives just as it is that things are close to boiling over. A naturally intuitive person senses that something has been going on.
Is everyone excited for the final day of school? Claudia, how's that hand feeling? I'm sure you'll be back in fighting form just by this afternoon. Aren't you concerned about my hands, Colonel? Yesterday I almost broke a nail winning so hard.
Wow, bitch.
Technically, I don't believe a winner was decided, but your presentation was quite impressive.
What is he doing complimenting her?
Learn not to be so jealous. Jeez, British narrator guy.
But what about my... What about the flavor of my delicate, warm, gooey chocolate sauce?
It was clear that you're passionate about how your food is received.
lot of words to say. It was bland.
Excuse me, Claudia. I am more than capable enough to speak for myself. Oh, that was me? Oh, sorry. I thought that was her.
Maybe you can tell me more of your thoughts as we walk into class, Colonel.
I'm always interested in discussing the fine art of fine foods. See you inside, Claudia. I wish I could have a choice to not say that. I wouldn't have said that.
One word by Colonel Sanders, and there's an inability to see Ashley for who she is. She really is. You walk across the quad to get some distance.
Nah, he probably sees. He's just messing with her, most likely.
In an attempt to distract yourself from how slighted did you feel by that interaction with Ashley, take out a spellbook you covered yesterday and start flipping through the pages.
Oh, I still have it? I thought that Ashley took it. Well, that's that book. It looks like bad news.
It's just something I found laying around. What appeared to be some sort of grimoire, but I don't really believe in that magic stuff.
A grimoire? Like a book of spells? I don't know. Who would spend so much time decorating a magic book if it weren't really powerful?
I can think of one surefire way to find out. You open to a page covered with arcane warnings.
Cast only in case of extreme emergency.
And it says around the edges of the paper. I could use this spell here that says it will erase anyone I choose from all of my memories. If I scrub out Colonel Sanders, it would probably help me focus better on the upcoming final exam.
No!
That is way drastic. Couldn't you do something else, like anything else not rooted in dark magic? Maybe tie a string around your finger?
Okay, fine. It is drastic, but desperate times call for desperate measures. You've got a memory erasing spell sitting right in front of you. And a pretty good excuse to try it out.
Don't do it after all.
No, I don't want to. You take your friend's advice and put the book away. It's almost time for class. Sprinkles is already in the room, waiting for the students to arrive. He clears his voice to make a quick announcement.
I feel something of a dark moment coming on, but I can assure you it's nothing to be afraid of.
His cute little nose scratches up again. Up and he begins to breathe quickly. Wait and see what happens. Right, this one. Twinkle stops in his track, focus in on the window. The room is deathly silent. When you follow his gaze, you see a tiny orange squirrel perched out on the cherry tree outside. Oh, that kind of thing. Spingles turns pale and runs to the window of the classroom. He begins barking uncontrollably at the squirrel.
Terrence, I told you never to come back here, Terrence. I will destroy you, Terrence.
Spingles is barking ferociously, flying off of his face. The squirrel looks over, but he doesn't say anything back. I wonder, is that even a talking squirrel? Who named him Terrence?
You better not show your chubby cheeks around here ever again!
After Sprinkles is satisfied that his presence has been felt by not only Terrence, but any other squirrel in hearing distance, he returns to his professional tone.
Ahem! I apologize for the outburst. This actually brings me an important point. Thank you, Claudia, for reminding me to dwell at this indispensable bit of wisdom. You see, before you can go any further, Miriam spills drama spills over into the class.
Holy crap. Before you can go any further, Miriam's love drama spills over into the class. Nels is interrupted by a sad whimpering coming from the back of the room. What is it?
I told you to save it for after class,
but I miss you.
We went on one date, Pop. And how can you miss me when I'm right here?
Pop's voice quivers as he pleads his case to Miriam.
Every time I blink, you go away again.
That's a really cute thing to say. Miriam, what happened between you and Pop?
I got her in trouble, and now she's mad at me. I didn't just get in trouble. I got yelled at by Pop's mother, who blames me for getting him banned from every museum we set foot in.
He goes inside museums? Oh, so that's what you meant by Shush House. Oh, thank God. Oh, thank God. I thought it meant something much worse.
Pop, we went on one date. We're over. It meant so much that I made this for you.
Do we have to go on arguing? Pop leaves his, creation behind and runs out of the room. Nothing like a loud public breakup to cast a pall over the final day of school.
Well, that was unfortunate. But we mustn't get me distracted from what lies ahead. The final competition showdown challenge exam. I'm still working on the time, but I think you get it. Test time approaches. See you all in the arena, Arf.
But before you can think about your upcoming competition, there's a very beautiful soul in need of a pep talk. Hey, Miriam. Are you okay?
Okay. I'm so mad I could smash a tiny mug, spilling several droplets of hot cocoa all over the floor. How could he embarrass me in class like that, in front of everyone?
A tiny cocoa is a delicious treasure, so you know that this breakup is no joke, even if the source of her frustration is such a silly little boy, who's probably like 5 and she's going on a date with him, but let's not talk about that. I know that you know this, but I'm gonna say it out loud. You don't need anyone. Me and you, we're gonna cruise through this final test and hit the carpool lane to get your success city. Miriam brightens up, imagining the winds rushing through her short bangs, but she hesitates to embrace the feeling all the way.
Going to settle up on Colonel Sanders Stallion and ride off into the sunset without me.
Of course not, well, maybe sort of, but I'm sure there's a pony out there with your name on it, and a ranch big enough for both of us and whoever else we want to bring along. It's not Pop or Clank or anyone else you met today, tomorrow, or this whole year, so what? If it's not Pop or Clank or anyone else you met today, tomorrow, or this whole year, so what? You're a special person who shouldn't settle for this first, for someone to show a little interest anyhow. Miriam gives you a big hug and wipes the tears from your eye, from her cheeks.
I should really review my menu for today. I'm going to make a very special soup.
Ooh, soups.
And I bet Professor Dog is gonna love it.
Pop. While you were pep-talking Miriam, you completely missed lunch. But that's okay, because you had a better idea of how to spend your time before your exam. You've decided to head to the arena early to practice a dish. And thanks for being smart. This is it. The location of your final challenge. A test of will. A test of courage. A test of challenge. Of talent. And a chance to beat the pants off of Von Von, this supposed Marmon, and his evil counterpart, Ashley. As planned, you begin to run and do a quick make test of a recipe you've been working on. Claudia's famous chicken pot pie. Do they sell that at KFC? I don't remember. I usually get the giant chicken burgers. After practicing for months, making this dish comes up from second nature to you. And you're able to quickly got a fresh pot pie in the oven, but as soon as you do, the cramp session is interrupted by Colonel Sanders.
Claudia, what are you doing here? There's still time before the final exam.
Oh, just taking it all in. I'm big into visualizing success. I'm looking at my station and picturing victory. The pot pie has begun to bake, and smells slowly filling the space around you.
Visualizing, huh? That's too bad. I was hoping you were here to cook something delicious.
You'd usually happily share your food with anyone who is hungry, but the last time you let Colonel Sanders get in your head, it cost you a cook-off. You said it's time to put your cooking above your romantic desires, but that decision gets hard to stick when the oven timer goes off behind you. Let's talk about your dish.
Okay, you got me.
I'm doing a little bit more than visualizing.
I know. My nose can smell pot pie from 400 yards.
That's an oddly specific difference, but you'd expect nothing less from such an oddly specific man. You knew it was a pot pie, just from the smell?
Not just a pot pie, but a chicken pot pie. With an all-butter crust. Oh my god, all-butter crust. And my nose is telling me something else.
Oh no, is it burning?
Ha ha ha. No, I can smell that it was made with the helping of TLC. But it'll probably start burning any second if you don't pull it out.
The moment of truth.
Wow.
What? Wow. It's the best pot pie I've ever tasted. I've always loved country cooking and I could eat this all day.
I love country cooking too. Cracker Barrel, one of my favorite restaurants. There's no time left. The final showdown is about to begin. Sprinkles lays down the ground rules.
What is except to cook with everything you've got?
Step up for the cook-off of a lifetime. You decide that mac and cheese plus pot pie you've been talking are just the dishes that'll push you over the edge to victory.
Yes, finally, the mac and cheese.
Oh, I love myself some mac and cheese. Meanwhile, both Von Von and Ashley are prepping wildly elaborate dishes, put as usual over the top shelf. Miriam has her giant magnifying glass and several sets of tweezers. She's definitely prepared to go big, going small. Colonel Sanders seems to be harnessing his 11 herbs and spices. He's trying to find a way to improve on something perfect. His original recipe, rest their trademark, fried chicken. The intensity in the room starts. I pull 10 out of 10 for frenzy of action. Everyone is calling out really cool special cooking moves as they prepare their food.
Wow, this is getting serious.
Colonel Sanders battles his chicken as it levitates through the air.
Wow. Egg wash.
Miriam furiously injects ingredients into a itty bitty pot of broth.
Pet friend, face their blaster.
Von Von flexes his pectorals as he chops open a sea urchin.
Let's rock and roll.
Ashley scoops her pastries off the tray with lightning speed.
Shallow personality spatula.
Even Clank gets in on it.
Five dial pressure point cooking, chicken cooking technique.
Wait. When did Clank learn to speak English?
It's the singularity.
As was foretold. We mustn't let it happen or the appliance upsizing will take us all off.
Stop this breath.
Von Von quickly unplugs Clank and rolls him out of the back door of the arena.
As you frantically prepare your dish, you notice Ashley has her spell book out. Is she going to use some dark magic to turn the tide? You've got a book of your own, and you're desperate not to see her win another battle. Should you take the opportunity to fight magic with magic, even if it's almost certainly evil magic?
What was the Colonel say?
The easy way and the hard way. And the easy way and you go nothing by going the easy way. Do it the hard way.
Who needs magic when you've got passion?
I'm going to do it the hard way.
Colonel Sanders sees that you've chosen to win on your own terms, and he gives you a subtle wink from across the room.
I believe in you, Claudia.
Miriam knows this too.
Aww.
And I've always believed in you, Claudia, since we were little kids, because you're my best friend forever.
You turn to notice that Miriam is at your station, cheering for you. Miriam, what about your dish? If you're here cheering, who's cooking?
Tiny food, short cook time. I'm actually already done, so I thought I'd help you.
Oh, that's sweet, but... Miriam tosses a handful of spices directly into your boiling noodles. No!
Aha!
It's the secret ingredient.
However, she doesn't know that you lied. I didn't know this ingredient was made up in. Where in the world did she get Eye of Newt from? The boiling pot explodes, sending Miriam flying backwards, and water and noodles begin to swirl in the air, bubbling up into a dark cloud that thickens and congeals before your very eyes.
It is I, the Spork Monster!
Yay, it's Borko! Wait, Steve? Wait, what happened to Borko? You're not here to battle me, are you? Oh my gosh, there's a second Spork Monster.
We Spork Monsters are many. I think Borko had the day off. But you have conjured Steve, and I hate to battle. So I'd say you're doing pretty alright. Hey, you're in the middle of a cooking competition. I love the star. It's better than TV. You crazy kid in your culinary schools really impressed me. Mind if I hang out?
No, I could give him a different voice, but no, I like his voice. I'm sorry, Steve, but I'm kind of in the middle of something. Do you mind? Steve, the Spork Monster, notices that you've got the grimoire stashed beneath your cooking station.
I see what you're up to. Crisscrossed some magical items and accidentally summoned me, huh?
Yeah, you guessed it, sorta. If you're here, would you mind tossing some fresh noodles in a pot of salted water?
I'd love to! I always wanted to be top chef, actually. You know, when I was just a little spork pup. Back in the old country.
You feel Spork Monster winding up to tell you a very long and involved story. You don't know exactly where they came from, but it seems like it was probably lonely there. You know what? I'm gonna give him Russian accent. He's from a faraway country, he's gonna be Russian. Actually, you know what? Maybe you should watch from the stands. I really need to focus on the competition.
I understand. It's kind of like that time I'm in monster school that I had fallen asleep during scare tactic class, and when I woke up,
you toss a serious stare at Steve, and he takes the hint.
Never mind. I'll tell later. Good luck.
Having suffered from a huge setback, you don't know how you could ever win. You summon extra power from the deep down within you.
I can do this. I got what it takes. I came here to win.
Your hair turns mac and cheesy orange and culinary energy flows through your body.
We went Super Saiyan. Nice.
My heart is pure. My weak hands are steady. My taste buds. I've been preparing their entire lives for...
Yes, Claudia. You are the chosen one. You will avenge me.
Get out of here. The power you've been summoning immediately fades back out.
You interrupted my inspiring monologue.
Sorry.
My heart's pure. My weak hands are steady. My taste buds are ready. These pets have been preparing their entire lives for this moment. I will show the world my cookery. You begin to levitate off the ground, and of course, passes through your body. You know that with this power, you can do anything. Except come back time, which would be super useful, because while you are piling up, your chicken pot pie will cook in the oven and can't be served. Crap! What about the one from earlier? Don't worry, dear Toddy. You may have suffered some setback, but all is not lost. Impressed with your fortitude, Paul Sanders decided you have earned his support.
I've been watching you today, and I must say, I'm truly impressed. You've been thinking on your feet and rolling up the punches.
He steps up to your station and stands right beside you.
I'm here to help.
Bobby managed to make his mac and cheese, and time is almost up, so you're going to need it. But Colonel Sanders, what about the test? What happened to you? What about the rules?
Following the rules have never been in my thing. I must follow my heart.
What? Oh, guy, he's so dreamy. Look at those eyes. That mustache. That goatee. That hair. What a guy.
Colonel Sanders unfolds a delicate white towel and reveals the most delicious fried chicken tenders you've ever laid your eyes on.
And besides, sometimes unexpected combinations can have surprising effects. That's a path to individual effort.
Are you suggesting?
If we combine forces, we can form the perfect food unit. Ah, is it going to be a chicken bowl? I love those things.
Time's up, students!
Time expired. It's the moment everyone has been waiting for. And yes, I say chicken bowl because in the opening animation for this game, he serves a chicken bowl and it looks delicious.
You must now prepare for present your dishes.
A handful of students stand tall. The class seems incomplete.
It seems we are missing some students. Pop? Clank?
Off screen, you hear a pure and innocent giggle that can only come from one student.
I'm flying!
It sounds like it's coming from the broom closet over there.
Miriam, would you mind?
Inside the closet, you see Pop hanging on a broom, hooked by the elastic of his underpants.
Pop! Get out here right now!
Let me guess. Did Von Von have something to do with this?
When someone asks for a wedgie, who am I to refuse, Fuse?
I thought a wedgie was a salad!
It looks like Pop is eliminated from the challenge, seeing how he didn't cook anything.
I can't feel my legs. May I be excused?
Sure. You kids and your pranks, I must say, it's not the worst prank making UCSAL history. But it's not exactly yearbook material. Wait a second. Pranks? Pranks? Clank! Where did that pressure cooker roll off to?
You wait to hear for your signature beep or utter onomatopoeia, but there's none. He's outside.
Somehow he must have gotten unplugged, I guess. We'll have to figure that out later.
He's outside. I remember earlier Von Von sent him outside.
That leaves only 4 remaining students. Please collect your final projects.
Yes.
It has been a long semester,
a long 3 days. Wow, 3 whole days long.
But after days of hard work, the time has come for me to eat.
This whole thing was just to get a dog to eat.
Miriam, please step forward. Now, describe your dish.
I've made...
Oh my god, it's so cute.
Tender and maneuvers and savory soup.
My word, it's so delicate. Is that a teeny weeny tiny Nortomakai? I spy a float in this itsy bitsy itsy bowl?
Yes, Chef.
Please, call me Sprinkles. Chef is my father's name.
I won't be surprised.
Yes, Sprinkles. And some green tea I made from baby tea leaves that I picked myself.
Oh god, no, I hope this ain't good.
Sprinkles
carefully sniffs the dish before opening his mouth and letting just the tip of his pink dog tongue dip into the bowl.
Sublime! Would anyone else like a taste? Oh, come on. I'm not one of those dogs who doesn't floss. I have a really cute electronic toothbrush for dogs. Fine, I'll join all by myself.
I kind of want to see that toothbrush. And in a flash, the entire meal has been devoured. Not that it took much, it was less than a thimble's worth of soup.
A plus! Really do I taste a dish that is so much, with as much love poured into it as yours.
Miriam is overjoyed. She gives you a hug.
Thank you, Claudia, for helping me believe in myself.
Omelette, you're up. Now, describe your dish.
I made. When you eat the smooth custard eggs in an axe hue and urchin still topped with caviar.
Did you skewer one type of urchin with spines? Did you skewer one type of urchin with spines from a second different colored type of urchin?
Yes, Sprinkles.
Bit much, don't you think?
That's exactly why I did it. A bit much is kind of my brand. Doesn't it look cool?
Sprinkles leans in to sniff the uni, but he can't get his nose close on account of all the spikes. He begins to paw at it erratically, causing the custard to sloosh around.
Woof! Woof! Woof!
Please be gentle with my cuisine.
Finally, Sprinkles goes all in tongue first as he... But he can't get past all the needles. He reels back as his tongue is poked and prodded.
Ouch! My tongue!
The professor appears to be having an allergic reaction to the sting.
I can't eat this! It's keeping my poking in my tongue! I can't eat this! It kept poking my tongue! Disqualified!
A stunning turn of events. Who could have thought that serving food in a bowl made of needles could make it difficult to eat? Dejected, Von Von does not go so gentle into the night.
Disqualified? For glamour? Glamour?
Don't discount simplicity!
This isn't the last you've heard of me.
Before forcing us to endure his swollen tongue for another moment, Sprinkles graciously laps up a bowl of milk.
I know. I'm a dog and I drink milk. Get over. Sometimes it helps calm my agitated tongue. And no, I'm not part cat, so don't even ask. Next student, Ashley, it's time to step up. Now, describe your dish.
I made orange blossom Turkish delight and a light rose water syrup toppled with French marinade and connected by sugar glass.
That actually doesn't sound too bad.
Indeed, it's quite delightful. However, I'd ask that you please refrain from eating it or attempting to taste it in any way. It's very fragile and meant to be a display piece.
Don't eat the food at a cooking show?
Got toast in your ears or something, Claudia? I told you, it's a display piece.
Ashley, I must say, it is beautiful. However, this is a cooking competition at a cooking school.
Yeah, which is why I cooked it and did an extremely good job cooking it, too. I didn't realize that we were having an eating exam. If I wanted to be judge on eating, I'd go to the College of Eating School for the hungry. I suppose you could smell it if you absolutely insisted, but don't breathe too hard. You might disrupt the sugar spiral.
This food cannot be eaten and cannot be judged. You are disqualified.
Rage overtakes Ashley, and she finally cannot keep her two-faced routine up.
You wouldn't know high-end cuisine if it cooked you!
And with that, Ashley storms out to rededicate herself to being the best, but this time without being shackled by trying to be fake nice and liked by everyone.
This isn't the last you've heard of me, either!
If this class gets much smaller, I'll be teaching myself!
You and Colonel Sanders, the final cook, step up together.
Two chefs?
What began as a bowl of delicious mac and cheese has become something else. He examines, oh my gosh, it's the chicken bowl. Oh my gosh, I'm so happy. He examines it closely, sniffing and eyeing the bowl. Uh-oh, I don't have a good feeling about this. From somewhere in the room, a little drum roll plays.
Just when I thought I've seen everything in the kitchen, you give me this. This thing. It completely blew me away. In my 49 dog years of life, I've never tasted anything so delicious and perfectly balanced. It's so delicious. In fact, that everyone passes the class.
Aw, oh, crap, no.
You pass, and you get a pass.
Thanks, Oprah. I'm so happy to get this free climbing pass. If it battles around and partakes, except the mac and cheese ball, they still seem to transcend this reality into another dimension. You win! Together, you and Colonel Sanders have made a new menu item. New menu. Item is so impressive that even Von Von and Ashley are drawn back in it by its majestic fragrance. From the gaze upon your mac and cheese bowl, admit that you are indeed an excellent chef. And they cry, tears going down their eyes. Pinkles declares that you have passed. Everyone has passed. There were supposed to be more bottles, but come on. How could they be better than this one? Now that the school year is complete and everyone has graduated, students return for their last assignment to get their groove on. Oh yeah, boy! The cafeteria has been completely redecorated in order to serve as the site of school graduation dance. Compared to the Marseille high-tech cooking arena, the humble decor seems downright cute and cozy.
Teacher Dog is in the house!
You knew that Sprinkles was a master chef, but also a world-renowned turntablist? Who says you can't teach an old dog new trick? Von Von and... Oh god, Von Von, that's so much. Von Von and Ashley tell everyone that they committed themselves to righting the wrongs they did while they were the villains. For a moment, you actually believed them. Not another haunting.
It's clearly written in the school bylaws.
I was never actually a ghost. It was all a trick to get you to finally notice me.
Oh my god, he's still alive.
Oh, amusing.
And now that everyone is together, it's the spork monster.
But it's the spork monster. He has totally mellowed out.
Everyone, spork.
If he totally mellowed out, I'm gonna do a normal voice now. Everyone, the spork monster is no more. From here on out, I prefer that everyone refer to me as my new name, Party Monster, or Spork Party. Nah, Party Monster is better. Students tried to finish what they had to say, but everyone was too wrapped up talking to Spork. Sorry, Party Monster. Dejected, student walks off. Maybe things didn't work out for Miriam romantically, but she sure found the love in her cooking, and you know she's gonna do great. A red cop rolls off across the phone bomb. It's like a Hollywood movie career. Who could command such an entrance? It's Pop. He arrived late to dance, but apparently for good reason. Walking the carpet, you see perched atop his dirty chef's hat. A crown?
Welcome back, Pop. I know you weren't able to complete the final exam and accept your diploma, so we had it mailed directly to your father. We figured it was the least we could do for the school's dean.
He's been the school's dean this entire time? Oh my gosh, that's a twist. Oh, now I get it.
Getting a new ring at the school, not to mention that the honor of educating the son of the chancellor of such and such.
Miriam, will you be my king, my lady king?
What an incredible turn of events, an offer to join the royal family, the son of the dean.
Wow.
It's like a dream come true. You get to be a princess, or maybe a queen. I'm not sure if he even knows, but either way, crowns and gowns, baby.
I'm sorry, Pop, but I'm not interested. Not now, at least. I've got so much to do with my life.
A twist on a twist.
So many 3-day universities to attend. So many tiny foods to meticulously sculpt and then watch get accidentally blown away by a single sneeze.
Okie dokie.
The music at the dance is interrupted by the sound of sparking and electrical hissing. It's Clank, who has arrived late to the dance.
Now that I have graduated, I can reveal my truth.
Whoa, he's still doing the talking thing.
I am Clank, and I am not of this earth. I am actually from a faraway planet in another dimension.
What? I don't know, that's weird. Hey, but I don't see exactly how that confirms what? Little Family Guy reference? What?
I actually feel like I knew it the whole time. Knew it this whole time. Now that I have learned the ways of your kind, I must return.
A portal opens up and Clank disappears through it. Finally, Colonel Sanders arrived. Does he finally get to wear his jacket?
Aww. Howdy. Howdy there, classmates.
Just like the first day you met him, he has come prepared to feed the entire class. However, it's not enough just to give them a bucket of chicken. This time, it's a full meal. Oh my gosh, it's so delicious.
I didn't get to be the most famous chicken man in history. In the history of chicken, and man, not by not reminding people well, to go out and buy my chicken.
Oh my gosh, that's funny. I like that joke. The end? Could this be the end?
Well, if this is the end, guys, thank you so much for watching this video. If you liked it, please subscribe and have it really help out. If you liked the series, like and comment down below. And I'll see you in the next video. Buh-buh-bye!